Hi and welcome. My name is Nedžad Gicic and I'm coming from Authority Partners Company, and today we'll talk about processing big data with Hadoop in Azure.
You can see on my slide session objectives. We'll explain what big data is, what is Hadoop. We'll talk a little about methods, what is HD Insight, about tools related to HD Insight cluster tools. I will show you a few demos. One is provisioning an HD Insight cluster, and another one, it is related to running a MapReduce job. Okay, what is big data? Big data is data that is too large or complex for analysis in traditional relational databases. So it is not just about size of data, it's more about complexity of the data. So when we talk about big data, often it's called something about 3Vs. 3V stands for volume, variety, and velocity. Volume, what does it mean? When we have a huge amount of data, actually traditional relational databases can handle huge amount of data, but it's not just just about the volume, it's more about variety. I mean, complexity. When I say variety, imagine the problem that you have a mixture of structured and unstructured data. You have some structured data, say clean data, and some unstructured data. A good example for that is social media sentimental analysis. So you have some three, four of text, and you have, for example, some images, some videos, and things like that. So you want that processing, that kind of data will be not be easy with traditional relational databases. So that's a real challenge, real problem for big data. That was the third V. That was the second V. The third V is velocity. When you have a situation that data is arriving very quickly and you want to capture the data, to process the data and to display, to visualize the data, that is about the velocity. The good example is if you have some sensors, some data or data from Internet of Things, and you want to display some events in real time. That is the third velocity, third B. Yeah, for the huge volume, good example is web server clickstreams. You want to process the logs file from your web page application to count the number of clicks and etc. There major problem areas and solve using Hadoop, there are three major problem areas. It's a batch processing, real-time processing, and predictive analytics processing. Predictive analytics. What is batch processing? When you have huge amount of data, you want to visualize it, to display it, so it's necessary to clean it because it's unstructured data, to filter it, to shape it. It could be that you have some missing values, you want to remove that missing rows, or you want to repopulate some missing values, to interpolate that values, and set. That is the batch processing. And in this lecture, we will focus on batch processing because it's a core scenario for the Hadoop. Second major problem that we can handle and solve with Hadoop is real-time processing. Again, imagine a situation that you have that time is arriving very quickly and you want to capture the data and to manipulate with it, filter aggregate streams of data for low latency querying, clean the data, display and visualize it in the real time. And the third problem that we can handle with Hadoop is predictive analytics. What does it mean, predictive analytics? It's more related to data science, but also big data could be involved in it. So, simple words, we have some historical data, and based on historical data, we create some model, some regression classification, prediction model, let's say prediction model, and with that prediction model, we predict the future data. Okay? We will focus on batch processing in this question. What is Hadoop? Hadoop is an open source cluster technology. Hadoop is an open source distributed data processing cluster technology. That's the best definition. Open source distributed data processing cluster technology. What does it mean? It means that open source it's under Apache platforms and cluster. That means that you have, you see the picture, yeah? That you have a set of the servers or virtual machines or nodes, we call it nodes, and they work in team like the one. So it's important here to understand that Hadoop is not one big server, some big processor. It's a cluster, a set of nodes, set of servers. So here we have a name node. Name node, some main node, let's say brain node. It accepts the requests from client applications and let's say delegate to the data node or worker node. So we have at least one name node, but typically it's necessary to implement another one for redundancy. And we could have several data nodes, and data is processed in HDFS, which stands for Hadoop Distributed File System. What does it mean? It means that Hadoop Distributed File System, these data nodes can share one file, can read, access one file, but important thing is that they can share the content of that file, and each of these nodes can work on small piece of content of this file. Okay? That means HDFS. Resource management is performed by YAR, which stands for yet another resource negotiator. It's like coordinator, and it coordinates the works, processing works in the cluster. Okay. What is MapReduce? MapReduce is one of the techniques that's used to actually process the data in Hadoop. Okay. I will show you some simplest example just to figure out how it works. Let's say we have some table. You see we have invoice, we have date, we have amount. And I want to calculate the total amount of money that was invoiced on a particular date.
You can see the dates are spread across 3 days here. We have one date, same date, other date, and this is the same date. So MapReduce process has two phases. First phase is mapping. Mapping is converting this data into the key value pairs. You can see there are three keys, and every key has, you don't see my notes. Okay. Every key has a value. First key has two values, second key has one value, etc. So this is the first phase. Map phase, converting data to key value pairs. We split the data and convert it to key value pairs. Next phase is reduce phase. What we can do, what we are doing with in reducing phase, we do some process on with value, some aggregate function. In this example, I want to calculate reduce. I will show you another one, the hello world of the MapReduce. Imagine that we have some sentence from some log files. You can see that sentence, lorem ipsum, etc. So it's necessary to do following steps. Source text is divided among data nodes. So the left table could be one node, could be processed by one node, and the right table could be processed with second node. So we have, you can see here, keys are just splitted values, words, you know, and value, I just put it one, it's just like a placeholder. That means that word, appropriate word, exists in appropriate sentence. So this could be processed by one data node. You know, we have, remember, we have name node and data node. They can split, if you remember the previous sentence, I will repeat that. Again, it's important. They can share the files, read the files, and share the content of the files. So one sentence can be handled with one node, other sentence with another node. Okay? We split that, put the one values, and in the next phase, this is a map phase, we just sum how many times appropriate word appears, see lorem one time, see three times, etc. Reduce phase aggregates values for each key by adding the values for each word. That's it, the hello world of MapReduce. MapReduce is a technique of Hadoop. Okay? Here is example of code. Map, and reduce code. It's written in Java because Java is the most commonly used language for writing this type of MapReduce code. We have a mapper and reducer. Let's call it. This is what a MapReduce job looks like. And we create a jar file and upload it to the HDFS. And after in jar file, we can call this function. I will show you that in demo. What is HD inset? HD inset is simply word Apache Hadoop running on Azure. It's an instance of the Hortonworks Hadoop distribution running on virtual machines. You can see that there is HD clusters with virtual machines. We don't worry about managing the servers. or anything like that. We get here virtual machines configured as a cluster, as a team. When I say cluster, it's a team. So rather than the storage being managed by the actual hard disk, we move the storage into the cloud. You will see that in demo, I will show you how to configure some HD inside cluster on Azure, and you will see that. What else here is important? Advantage. We have separated the actual storage from the processing in the cluster. You see here storage, and here processing in the cluster. We set up HD inside cluster, and we will have some storage, process some data, store it into the storage, and we can take down the HD inside cluster to avoid charging, you know. This demo is provisioning an HD inside cluster. How to create? So simple, just go to create a resource. Under the data and analytics, you can find HD inside cluster. So basics panel is open. We need to enter some unique key, for example, 1, 2, 3. It's validating here. Should be okay. Okay. This is my subscription. Configuring. Cluster type. We talk about Hadoop, so we can choose Hadoop type. Linux, last version. Select, go on. Cluster login username. Admin manager, cluster login password, enter, should be okay. Username, SSH, manager. Okay. Resource group, create new resource group. You can choose existing. You see, I have, but I will create a new one. HD inside resource group. And location, I will choose West Europe. Important here, you should note all this because you will use it. So, especially username, password, password, SSH username, etc. Next, storage tab should be open. Okay. Here is what I talked in the previous slides. What type of storage you want? Azure storage or data lake storage? I will choose Azure storage, my subscription. You can choose storage account, but I will create a new one. HD inside ST. Okay, default container. You can also choose SQL database for Hive. Next. Summary of the data that you just entered. What's important here? Cluster size, I think here. Yeah. Remember this. Number of worker nodes. name node and worker node. Number of worker nodes, I will put this most. I don't need for them. I will choose the lowest. This should be lowest price. This one. For the head node. This one should be, yeah. Select. And that's it. This optional validity. And now, if I, one more thing, you see here, download template and parameters. I can download here template, download, to avoid again to enter this username, password, etc. and just load this template, and again it will create the same HD insert cluster. Okay, this process, it takes almost half an hour, so I've already done it for you. I already created this HD insert cluster. I will not hit create here, just show you that I have already that cluster. You see, it's HD insert cluster, it's in this storage account. And when you click this, you can see the properties. Okay, I will continue with presentation. Some HD Insight tools. There is a web browser on the second demo. We have a dashboard in the Azure Management Portal. Also, we have some secure shell client tool like Apache. Also, you will see that in demo to access the head node of the appropriate HD Insight cluster. Also, there is a Azure command line interface, PowerShell, etc. We can, with PowerShell, create HD insert, some scripts, run scripts, etc. What's important here with these tools? We are using Azure Storage to store the files there. So, to access some file, we need some Azure URL. And that is implemented with WASB protocol here. So these things, we store files in Azure Blob Store. Azure Blob Store are stored in the container, and containers are in some account. So to access some file, you'll see that in demo, you enter container, WASB protocol, container name, account name, and this appropriate path to the appropriate file. Or you can use the shorter one if you're in default storage account, or the next one. important here is to say that file paths are case sensitive. You can see also HDFS shell commands like list, make directory, remove directory, display directory, etc. Some of them I will show you in next demo. Running MapReduce jobs. Okay. How can we run some MapReduce jobs in HD Insert cluster? We need to do following steps. We need to compile executable MapReduce code, which is commonly written in Java. This is, I show you some example of code. And to upload that in HD Insert cluster, so every node can access to that code. We need to upload source data, and we need to run MapReduce executable on cluster with some commands. I will show you these commands. So we have Hadoop jar, name of the jar file, the source from which we want to read something, and source where we want to store that after processing with that MapReduce function. Then okay. You can see my Azure account again. We are in my created HD Insight cluster. So, client tool that I showed you in the previous slide, you have a dashboard SS. Etc. Okay. Another one, you can scale the cluster. Scale the cluster. Just enter, decrease the number of the cluster. Hit save. Okay. Secure shell. Here is my host name. What I'm going to do now? I'm running the Puppy client. I'm going to enter my local host name. Simplify here. In example, data. Okay. I enter this. Actually, I need to enter text, see a sample of content of DaVinci text file. You can see it's an unstructured data in DaVinci. Takes text file, and this is the path of that file. It's in root folder of the rich dataset cluster, example, data, bootender, and the rich data. What I want to do, I want to run MapReduce job. So when we're gonna to view sample Java jars that are stored in the cluster, I will enter this comment. You can see a lot of jars. I will find some specific one. Here is my word count function, which is in the package jar. This pet user current Hadoop MapReduce client Hadoop MapReduce examples jar. In that jar is that function. I show you example with example of code with map and reduce, and this I will invoke this function to read my DaVinci txt file to word count, to count the word of how many appropriate words there are in that file, and to store in another file in location that I will define. How can we do that? I will just copy this. Okay, I will show you here. Hadoop job. What does it mean? It means that I will run MapReduce function. Which function? What kind of function? Where is that function? In this job. Okay? And what I'm going to do with that? I will read DaVinci txt, here is the space, maybe it's not this one here. Read from this path DaVinci txt file, invoke this function, and result will be saved in the example result folder. And just to show you, I have here Azure Storage Explorer. You can see my blob containers. There is my HD inside cluster in here. And with this tool, I didn't mention Microsoft Azure Storage tool, we can explore our HD Insight cluster. You can see here is my cluster, and in example, in this folder, after I execute that code, it will create some example folder with some part underscore R file, processed file. You'll see that. Just copy this.
It's running, you don't see, unfortunately. It's running a map reveals. You can see here, maybe, map 0% reduce 0%. In the next phase, map is finished, 100% reduced 0%. Okay, it's finished. So, just to explain you a little bit here. Here, started, finishing mapping, reduce starting, finishing mapping, reduce, finished. You can see that job with some ID completed successfully, shuffle errors, etc. So now we should have here example folders. Results, sorry. In example, result folder. And here is my created file. So what next I will do? I will show this folder to double check that I have created these files, and I will show you the content of that file with this comment. HDFS, DFS text is for displaying. Okay. One more zero. Okay. You can see here, we have a word with count. How many some words appears in DaVinci TXT files. Any question for this one? Another example I wanted to show you. Okay, it was DaVinci TXT file. Next thing that I'm gonna do is to upload my file reviews. I will upload. You saw here there is an option to upload a folder on file. I will upload the folder, and inside reviews folder there is a reviews TXT file. Uploading is running. Uploaded, finished. I will do the similar thing. I will run MapReduce function word count, which is located here in this jar, this pad. Okay, I will read. So I'm invoking some function. Parameters is from where and to where store data. Source data is reviews. Why this pad? Because I uploaded storage in the root folder. Here, reviews. Okay. And this is where results should be after the finish. So I will just copy this comment. Run it. Again, hit started. Now he should create now in reviews. Okay, it's already created for the results. It's finished. And in results we have part, you see this file.
we can double check that it is created. You see the folder, and if you want to see the content of that file, I will just find format text. So that's it. Any questions? I have a few questions for you. You saw what we have just done. Compile MapReduce code and upload it. There was already on the htinsight jar file. You saw that right? Upload source data. It was in my example reviews.txt. In first part, I execute DaVinci.txt, read from DaVinci.txt. And second, I upload the reviews.txt file and run with that commands. MapReduce job to read from reviews and to store into results slash reviews slash that's it. Fine. Yeah. The command like that. You see, I do jar, my class, that means my function, source location, output location. Questions. Imagine that you have provisioned a Linux-based htinsight cluster and need to open a remote command line interface for the head node on your Windows-based client computer in order to run a job on the client. What should you do? Use the Windows remote desktop client to open a remote desktop protocol session to the cluster window. Use the Azure to open secure shell connection to the cluster name node. Install an SSH client tool such as PuTTY and use it to open secure shell connection to the cluster name node, or D. Install Linux because you can connect to Linux based cluster from Linux. And the answer is C. Bravo. You have provisioned an htinsight Hadoop cluster with two worker nodes. You need to process an unusually large batch of data, which is twice the normal size. And you want to reduce the time the processing will take to reduce the time. You must minimize disruption for other processes that are currently using the cluster. What should you do? Delete the cluster and then recreate with the former cluster with the same name. Dynamically increase the number of the worker nodes to 4, starting the data processing job. Delete the cluster and then recreate a one node cluster with the same name. Or you can dynamically decrease the number of the worker node to 1. Bravo again. And the last question. The default shared storage for an htinsight cluster is hosted in a container name ht123 in Microsoft Azure storage account name ht store. You create a folder named data in the root of the storage container and store a file named source.txt4. Which three of the following paths can you use to reference to the source.txt file? I heard it. That's it. Thank you for your time.